I've started.
What if you walk up to a girl and you're like, man, you look like a real horse girl. That's what you strike me as. I mean, okay. You just look like a total horse girl, you know?
Yeah. Anyways, hey, if you didn't know why we were starting it like that, it's because it's this game that has horse people.
I want to bring the gender pyramid to as many people as I can.
Horse boys, horse girls.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Horse
she does
clowns?
Not look good.
Oh.
Oh.
I want Ben Shapiro to...
Ben Shapiro is easily...
Pyramid.
Just,
he's definitely
boy.
A horse guy.
Oh, God, yeah.
For sure. But I want him. I want to explain the concept of the pyramid to him and then have him put himself on there.
So, if I'm a clown, I identify with no gender. Is that
so
right?
So, hypothetically, if I were a clown.
Oh, man.
It'd be a good thing to have him talk about so he can say some more embarrassing stuff.
Yeah. Last time, Z made out with Percy, I think,
oh, yeah.
To evade the cops.
We probably fucked him if that doesn't happen this time.
Yeah, and we still lied to Percy about why he's in trouble.
Yep.
I don't know what this
happened. I would both be mad
the next day.
If she did fuck him, and if she didn't.
Yeah.
She cannot win.
Yeah. You couldn't go back to Abby's house after your second and third cop murders of the year, and Abby couldn't exactly stay where she was either. Police would surely be knocking on her door again soon, especially considering it was her Bentley which was used to ram the car of the slain officers. So you rented an Airbnb close to your old restaurant and walked there once it was dark. Abby drove to meet you at the house, which is where you're all staying now until you could think of a better plan.
This footage is showing up everywhere. Oh, okay. I didn't. The phrasing threw me off. This footage is showing up everywhere I look. It's so surreal. How did we even get here, Z?
We got here because these shitheads don't know when to stop pushing it. I know that footage makes it look like I'm just icing these cops like a hardened criminal. But could I just remind everybody, this only started because a cop almost murdered me in cold blood. I was just defending myself that night, and that's all I was doing yesterday, too. I was defending Purse, too, because he didn't do
oh,
shit.
Oh, yeah, his name is Purse now, I forgot.
Yeah.
Okay, never mind. Purse looks about it.
He's like, hey, I think we did the right thing, guys.
I got fucking laid. All
I thought
right.
It just said that we couldn't go back to Abby's house.
Yeah, we didn't.
We're at an Airbnb.
Oh, yeah.
Come on, keep up.
I already forgot.
Why are there so many hands?
Well, I mean, aside from helping us rip off your parents, but that's a victimless crime anyway.
Sigh. Dot, 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 dot. Space. Yeah. You're right. It's not even that you're wrong about any of that. It's just... Gee dang. We are in so much trouble now.
Hold up, wait. They're talking about... her murdering cops in the night right in front of Percy, who...
Oh, no, in the day, if you recall. It was in
yeah,
the,
no, I'm also it, talking about at the night one.
Oh, okay,
about,
gotcha.
Oh, I guess that's fine, because Percy kind of already... Because that was already the media. Okay, now I'm putting things together in my mind, sorry. That's fine to talk in front of Percy, but the thing that wouldn't be fine is talking about how he is technically involved in those two, because she used his... God.
All right. Well, it's fine. She borderline sexually assaulted him. But he's happy about it, so it's cool.
Well, yeah. The cat is pretty much out of the fucking bag now, isn't it? There's really no denying it anymore now that the footage has made the rounds in the media. There are a frenzy over it. I'm thinking of just coming clean and telling our fans the original story.
Hard call. Percy's actually a serial killer.
I could see it.
It's just, you know, we're putting that one on the back burner. Well, for now. Are you sure that's a good idea?
Abby, have you even seen the discourse around this? Like, obviously corporate media is painting me as a bad guy, but everyone else, like the people who actually matter to our movement, they're talking about me like some kind of folk hero.
It's the most highly honored American pastime, as we know.
The This mishap is actually incredibly good for business. Just like it was when the news story came out linking me to the first dead cop. It's not even like I planned this shit, but it turns out waging war against the police is entirely compatible with the brand we're building here.
Yeah, that's a bit weird.
I also like that she described herself as folk hero because of the D&D 5e folk heroes. Feature rustic hospitality. Since you come from the ranks of the common folk, you fit in among them. You have a place to hide, rest, or recuperate among the commoners.
Among us.
Shut up. Unless you have shown yourself to be a danger from them. They will shield you from the law or anyone else searching for you, though they will not risk their lives for you.
That sounds so about right, actually.
She's just folk hero background, yeah.
Yeah.
Clown hero. I know that. You can see where I'm coming from, though. I'm just scared about what could happen to us. Like, we're in so deep with these money crimes, too. What if they find out about that?
Abby, they did find out. That's why the cops busted Percy, remember?
I thought they busted him because you sent them a photo of him one.
But that was an accident. Like, yes, Percy. I should have mentioned. Accidentally let a photo of you slip, but I didn't give your name or anything, and it was an innocent mistake. So maybe that's why they busted you. Who can even really say at this point?
Yeah, Percy doesn't have a high detailed close-up because he doesn't value himself as an individual yet. It's actually a very, deep and
character development.
Mm-hmm.
Pat. And anyway, I made a daring rescue attempt and killed your captors, and now here you are. So everything's cool, right? We're cool? You're still allowed to fuck me?
So I'm confused. Did the cops find out about our Bitcoin scams or not?
I mean, probably not. I doubt it, actually, but when you think about it, what crime is even being committed? To be honest, on paper, it really just looks like a father has been working out with his daughter to buy a bunch of bitcoins.
No.
No.
Yeah, no.
No. And the money just wound up in a family account. Your account. If they want to prove a crime was committed, I guess they can try. But from where I'm standing, it looks like cop murder caught on tape is the crime they're prepared to take a lot more seriously.
Yeah, probably.
Oh gosh. Hold on. My audio got all fucky for
a second. Yeah, I heard that too.
Which doesn't actually make me feel much better. I can't even go back to my house now. What about my horse? I need to feed him. I'm a horse girl after all.
Don't worry about Dave Hoof. We'll figure out a way to get that boy fed. I'll make sure he's the fattest horse on the island when all this is said and done.
He's just gotta start.
It's probably not a good idea to make him the fattest one.
Yeah.
I'm working on solutions to all this.
Not to doubt your master plan, but what could possibly be the solution to this? Are you going to use our billions to buy off the police?
No way. I'm not giving the cops a fucking dime of our hard-earned money.
Hard-earned.
Yeah. My plans were already in the works way before yesterday's incident. Percy's happy again.
I wish you'd actually let me in on all your secret plans. I'm your partner in crime. You're supposed to trust me.
I do trust you, Abs. I just don't always want to overwhelm you with too much information.
Yeah, she's cool.
Yeah.
She doesn't know what the fuck she's doing.
It's just a little prank.
True.
I'm not cheating on you, babe. It's just a little prank.
Dude.
You've been doing so great with your dad. It would be a shame to clutter your head with new things to worry about.
Well, now my head is really cluttered because of certain police assassinations taking place in broad daylight. captured on video, which are now going viral. So, can you just tell me what's going on?
You'll see. We're going to get some help soon. This is actually why I had Purse come today, yesterday. I'll need a hand in coordinating this.
What do you mean, help?
Earlier help.
She got the Rona!
Oh, hey, this is the one part where it looks like her tits are exposed.
Yeah, it kind of does.
No, this is literally the exact same shot.
Yeah, I know. It's just, I forgot that that was what we said.
I mean, everybody thought it.
I really hope it's not dot, dot, dot.
Could it be dot, dot, dot? I'm sure it's not that. I've just been pushing too hard, shooting cops, scurrying around, catching a little cold, that's all. Besides, I've been checking my toes every day. Not a single COVID toe in sight. Is that a thing?
Probably not. I think he just wanted to put toes in there. That's all I think.
Yeah, there we go.
Can I check out her toes? Haha.
As a joke, just to
that's a
make
joke.
Fun
yeah,
of
just as
ha
a meme.
Ha, yes.
I don't think that's really an indication of anything. I'd suggest you get tested, but dot dot dot.
Man, even people who aren't fugitives can barely get tested. Don't worry, I'm fine. Pretty sure I've got like herd immunity by now or something. So that's what you think, huh?
A single person can't have herd immunity. I thought you were supposed to be smart.
Think again, bitch. Have you been watching the story?
Classic socialism.
Anyway, I don't want to be late for this thing that's about to happen. Come on, Persh. Time to go for a drive. Yeah, that's a great idea. Go outside for a drive.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, I'm fucking happy as shit. I mean, Persh is... You and Percy head to Abby's car. She bought an BMW this time, which is a bit less noticeable than cruising around the island in a Bentley. There are a dime a dozen around here. You'll miss the Bentley, though. It served you well, especially in its final moments when it was used as a several hundred thousand dollar battering ram. Well, you are going to the complete other side. Percy has no idea where you're going. All he can do is glance at your phone sometimes, which you're holding for navigation purposes. You've set the destination for a place near Jackson Point, which is one of the westmost parts of the island. A place that can facilitate boating activity in a way that's much more discreet than anything going on by the docks near the downtown area. Okay, so she's gonna drive out in the boat? Maybe. A few times Percy attempts to make some small talk, you humor him, nodding along occasionally, turning your head to throw him a smile. Seems like he's skirting the topic of his feelings. Something like that. That's nice, Purse. You're super flattered and all. But it would behoove him to come to grips with the magnitude of what's about to take place on this island. In the not too distant future, some very loud noises may be assailing his ears, but they won't be coming from wedding bells.
She's gonna bomb the PD.
Oh, fuck no. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Yes! Anarchy! Anarchy!
You pull up near the docks and get out of the BMW to find a bunch of guys hanging around. Percy looks bewildered, but your confident demeanor reassures him that this is part of a plan. You study his reaction as he connects the dots. Of course he knows what's going on now. That he's seeing their reaction, not to him, but you. They're all looking awestruck as you approach. He realizes now that these are guys you invited to come to the island. Just like him, but they didn't come by ferry. They arranged their own transport via privately owned boats. You say nothing for a moment, taking it all in. You bask in the hushed reverence. Their disposition is becoming quite familiar to you. Just another bunch of simps for your collection. One with completely different utility than Percy. Ones with completely different utility than Percy. Ones that aren't nearly as soft. You begin eyeing some of the hardware they brought. Holy fuck. They're strapped. They came well equipped.
They came to work strapped.
They came well
equipped. What's the dude with the glasses got?
His arms. That's all he needs. Or not even that, actually, I guess. He has a life jacket.
He says, bitch, I am the weapon.
They came well equipped, just as instructed. These plans were in the works all week. And some of these boats took well over a day of sailing to get here. As you assess your new recruits, you can feel Percy fidgeting to your side. Clearly, he wants some answers. He's wondering why you didn't tell him about this earlier.
I'm telling you now, aren't I?
Fun fact, conspiracy is one of the things that you can get a life sentence or a death sentence for.
Wait, okay, by like what level of conspiracy?
Just conspiracy.
Like Alex Jones.
No, like conspiracy to commit crime.
Well, of course. Probably. I mean, yeah. He obviously can't dispute that. It's just that conspiracy to do something is very hard to prove in actual court.
I would say this constitutes
as conspiracy, yes. Yeah. Very much so. This would be one of the few times that you could actually pull it off. But his body language is still unsatisfied. That's fine. Now's precisely the right time to debrief him so he knows how he fits into the plan.
Sorry, Purse. This was top secret stuff. We were so busy with our financing operations, which were much more important. I've been back channeling with some of our most dedicated followers, ones in it for the long haul. Guys like you, you know? I asked guys with boats to rally other guys pretty close by. They organized low-key trips here to the west side. No ferries, no downtown action, no heat from cops.
He's clearly grappling with those behind-the-scenes logistics of this. The who's, the where's, the when's. That's...
Some of these boats are from the Massachusetts coasts. A few from Long Island. We got sailors here from all up and down the eastern seaboard, really. Last I checked with the guys on point, we had almost 20 boats headed here, but there might have been more added since. You wouldn't believe how psyched these guys were to get the invite. Well, maybe you would. They're good people. Just a bunch of dedicated, hardworking Jubilites ready and willing to step up and do some crazy shit.
So you mean complete and utter psychopaths?
Yeah!
Percy looks overwhelmed, maybe even intimidated to the untrained eye, but you know it isn't it. That isn't it. You can tell exactly what the look is. It's concern that his role of importance may be rapidly diminishing before his eyes. You put a stop to that quickly.
Don't worry, Purse. I brought you here for a reason. You'll be out front leading this crew in terms of the necessary logistics. Look at this shit. Just a bunch of dudes on boats after a long voyage, wondering what the fuck to do. Where they go, wherever. You'll take the reins on that.
You're gonna be the boy toy we pass around.
Oh no! My asshole.
But you gotta be careful, since the cops are still crawling all over this island looking for us. Okay?
He nods more confidently this time. Fucking Andrew Hussey looking ass. I don't know.
Push him off.
Please push him off. Yeah!
Red.
Yeah!
What the fuck do you think this is? Gathering the fucking juggalos? Well, it isn't. Not yet, at least. Don't worry. There'll be a time and place to wear the paint. But for now, you gotta play it straight. Plain clothes, plain faces. You're all just a bunch of average locals, understood? I booked you all a bunch of Airbnbs, so make yourself comfortable. And I don't see much of a reason why you should be making plans to honor your checkout dates, if you know what I mean. We're digging the fuck in. Everybody cool with that?
Squatter. Let's squat. Squat in our Airbnbs for a whole month, so we get squatters right.
Purse, make sure all these guys get to wherever they need to go. Ubers, taxis, rent some vans, jack some cars, however you want to do it. Counting on you, man. Get everyone moving. Now everybody get moving.
Queen!
Nice. Give Queen... clown queen gun. I've got some content to manage. This is what I want from the game from the start.
I'm so erect.
Sports, yo, sports. She's got the drip.
Sports.
16 million followers, holy fuck. After 2 weeks of constant media coverage of your recent exploits, your brand has skyrocketed. Both the video captured by a witness and the dashcam footage have been playing constantly. Members of the press have gathered on the island to cover the manhunt, while the police presence has grown. But the intensification of recent events hardly has been limited to circumstances on the island. The entire country has suddenly ignited in civil unrest over police brutality and the extrajudicial murders of black people at the hands of law enforcement. Something is stirring in America. Where is that dude's head?
It was all brought on by the release of Joker 2019.
Which dude?
The guy in front!
Oh, that's a cowboy hat.
His head is so fucking tiny, dude.
Yeah, it is.
I think it's just the clowns have the big clown fro.
No, no, like, his head is, okay, look, like, head to body look, here is, like,
look, dude,
one-tenth.
I don't know, I'm not about this body shaming thing you're doing right now, I don't know, okay?
He looks like he,
drizzles
a reverse bobblehead, for
gaming.
Fuck's sake. It's as if the more comfortable parts of the nation decided to finally wake up to the fact that they've been living on a police state for longer than most previously cared to admit. Oh, hey, Post Malone.
Post!
But you've noticed another development cropping up alongside this wave of racist political action, leeching off of the roiling energy of the nation. Jubilites have begun their own gatherings in huge numbers. At first, no one thinks much of. Another few gangs of painted buffoons slipped in between the garish Trump motorcades and doomed boat parades. But before you know it, you can barely point a camera anywhere without televising another preposterous gaggle of circus riff-raff clowned up behind their masks.
Man, I wish this happened. I wish just everybody
God,
was
I wish.
Just pointing cameras. You just saw clowns in the background.
Certainly too many clowns for the comfort of corporate media. But if you're being honest, maybe too many for yours as well. You begin to wonder what you've unleashed upon the nation. Holy fuck, dude. Quickly, social media seemed to realize that this was a different flavor of political action. The sheer number of clowns with guns roaming the street are making the people with all the money and power very nervous. Like, maybe the usual methods of media propaganda aimed at subduing these movements won't work on this crowd. There is a sense that once the clowns are out of the barn, closing the door won't do much good. And maybe there's something to it. As the police escalated their violent brutality in retaliation to the unrest, the Jubilites seized upon the chaos. Once they saw it was possible to drive police out of an area by force, they grew bolder in their aggression. No longer were your clowns a nameless gathering of oddities, a shy show of loitering farcisseurs. They were hijacking the political atmosphere towards their own objectives. And in turn, yours. Your detractors got a lot of airtime vilifying your followers for perverting a righteous social movement, and you find it hard to disagree with the point. But neither the slander from bad faith corporate shills nor the legitimate criticism from genuine activists ever seemed to stick. The spectacle of it drew even more people in. Who would begin wearing the paint? And the more painted faces show up, the more your movement appeared to stake its claim as a force entirely distinct from the origins of civil unrest. A force now taking the momentum of your once modest social media campaign and flooring it. And now it looks like police precincts everywhere may start falling like dominoes, and you see no reason to tell your people to take their huge floppy shoes off the gas pedal.
I want, like, a video out. Of, like, clowns with ARs just walking down the street, and you hear, like, the honk on each step.
Holy shit, this... The clowns kind of got their own fucking... They look like the final bosses that you see
of,
in,
like Kirby
silhouetted.
Games.
No, like...
They look like Kirby villains.
Yeah, kind
I was going to say, like, you know, like in the anime, where you can only see the silhouettes of like the 10 big bads. Like, this is that.
Yeah.
Like, I feel. Like, and you can tell, like, they each have their own unique thing. Like, the one with the huge ass droopy thing is, like, he carries around fucking right. something.
Viewers,
tag yourself in this photo.
Yeah, left to right, give each one of them, like, a code name and what their special power is.
The guy in, like, the top right is easily Bozo, and he's just, like, the strongest. Like,
I was thinking
just,
something like that.
Like, he's the one who forsaken all, like, other kinds of, like, you know, clownite, like, jujitsu or whatever. And he's just, like, brute force.
Fucking... He mind controls people.
I don't know. But you can't put too much personal focus on what's happening around the country because there's way too much happening locally you need to deal with. You've been ordering your new recruits to take care of business here on the island while you're in forced hiding. You have a team dedicated to make sure Abby's horse stays fed, for instance. With the help of Percy, an infrastructure of local Jubilite activity is beginning to emerge, which can operate somewhat autonomously from your direct supervision. Your inner circle directly overseeing this infrastructure has begun calling itself Ring 3. Oh, shit, boy. Fucking, we have the Akatsuki.
We got the upper echelon's name.
Yes, the Ring 3.
Tag the Ring 3.
Yes. It can't be the Ring 3. It has to just be Ring 3.
Yeah.
Being able to delegate important stuff and good news is good news, considering your health has been in decline. After showing symptoms of COVID-19, you decide to self-quarantine in the Airbnb. Abby and Percy rented another one across town whilst trying to stay out of view. Oh, so that's why we look like shit. Okay. Hold down the old fort by yourself. Holy shit, we have the gun right next to us. Nice. You have plenty of time. I love to plot and
scheme. The dude who made this, his name's Andrew Hussey, right?
Yeah. Hussey.
I think.
Hussey.
Yeah. I can't find his Twitter. I think... I'm scared.
Oh, no.
It couldn't be gone.
He has an Instagram, I know that much. Admittedly, this is not the most... You have plenty of time alone to plot and scheme in between your coughing fits and fevered visions. Admittedly, this is not the most fun you've had during your brand's rise to international notoriety. The carefree days of drinking expensive wine at Abby's house while in perfect health and bullshitting about gender. Oh my god, even... Oh, wow. Are starting to feel like a distant memory. But the administrative needs of your movement don't take a break just because you get sick. The show must go on. So the day you went with Percy to meet the first few recruits fresh off their boats, thousands of additional Jubilites have infiltrated the island using the same method. Those arrive at the western docks, usually at night. They unload and head back to the mainland for more, while the new recruits settle in wherever they can. Airbnbs and campsites, mostly. While some continue living on their boats, and others break into empty summer homes. Wow, this is fucking getting intense, holy shit. The fact that thousands of radicalized, plain-clothed clowns are now covertly occupying this island is the basis for the next series of operations you are planning. To the untrained eye, your schematics may appear to be total madness, but as you assure yourself frequently, it is anything but.
Burn it down, start over again.
That is probably what's going to happen. Like, holy shit. As far as you're concerned, your name could belong with the great tacticians of history someday. But only if you can maintain your focus and see this through. Which, you must admit, has been pretty difficult with this illness ravaging your body and mind. And with these damned visions getting more...
Hussey was definitely cooming as he was writing this. He was metaphorically and possibly physically just stroking himself off this entire chapter.
Oh, yeah. Music stopped. Fucking.
My anxiety attack.
There she was again. At least you think that was her. It's always hard to be sure when it's happening in your peripheral vision or the periphery of your imagination, you guess. It's strange that you've been seeing her more often than him lately. He was never far off from your disturbed hallucinations for obvious reasons. The way he died, the nature of the sickness, and what it did to him, it left a mark on your psyche that will probably never go away. But her? You just had a falling out and never spoke again. Is it guilt that's causing your mind to conjure her? You wrestled with the question for days until finally an unassuming email that you stumbled upon in your spam folder provides you with an answer. Someone was trying to collect on a medical bill of some sort, an ambulance fee. Actually, an ambulance that was used about 2 months ago. They're trying to collect the bill from you, but the person originally billed wasn't you. It was her. The fact that they're trying to collect from you instead of your mother must mean it couldn't be, could it? You do some more digging. You call the hospital where the ambulance dropped her off. After some time on hold, you can't believe it's not the fact that she's dead that blows your mind. It's the date, April 20th.
Woo! Which, for reference, is the day that the last chapter is supposed to come out to gamers.
It's also
the day
Lucina's birthday.
Also Lucina's birthday and all other good people's birthdays.
It's also Bakugo's birthday for My Hero, I think?
Oh, yeah, that sounds familiar, actually.
I don't fucking care. It's See, when all this good entire people. Story started.
And nothing bad has ever happened on April 20th. Yep. You cannot change my mind. That's it.
All good people.
Yeah.
First Bakugo bad thing was. Will for this to stop.
Yeah, he's good.
On that day, I guess.
Yeah, that's the only. That's gonna be the one bad thing.
Yeah. She caught COVID.
No more releases of this. Very sad.
Yeah, oh yeah. Dude.
True.
I'll be heartbroken. She caught COVID-19 in early April and died on 420, the day this lunacy all began. She's been dead for almost 7 weeks and you never even knew it. Aside from being stunned by the revelation, you feel nothing. You only had one bullet of grief in the chamber and you used that when your dad died. You made the most of that bullet too. Used it to drive yourself insane, quit school and run off to an island. If your dead mom is expecting any tears from you, she's shit out of luck. But you know she wouldn't be expecting anything of the sort. That's why she never called. Maybe she had different plans for you. Plans she didn't even know she had, or an impact on your life she didn't know she was causing. Perhaps it was the invocation of a dying woman from a dying curse from a bitter old woman, and that's what you've been contending with ever since the night she passed. You don't really associate the death of your parents with grief or loss anymore. That's just another one of society's lies, that these were things that you were supposed to feel. Instead, you feel like her departure represents a burdensome torch that is being passed, an inheritance of sorts. All the psychological baggage a parent accumulates over their whole life. And when they die, that lifetime of manic energy and striving and struggling and failures and disappointments, the failures and disappointments, the things they wish they became but never did, all of it has nowhere to go when the body dissolves, so it all flows right into you. That's how it was with your dad, watching him slip away slowly. The feeling of initial sadness for him gradually twisted into something that was nothing like sadness at all, more like a screaming inside that got louder every day. You watched his desperation grow as he knew the end was near. He was being devoured in his final days by the feeling that he wasn't given nearly enough time on Earth. He fell so far short of turning his life into the thing he once imagined it would be, and the results of staring into this abyss was utter panic. And where does all that panic go? Who feels the blame, the sense of accusation, the detrimented rage over the unfairness of it all? It was you. Your true inheritance is this tortured understanding, an implied contract since the day of your birth. That will be all that remains of his legacy. And now that it's up to you to bring meaning through familial continuity into a life he just went to painful lengths to make clear he barely even considered worth living himself.
One sec. I'm probably going to make this first line my new status. I'll just screenshot it and do it later.
I think I said that wrong. That now it's up to you to bring meaning through familial continuity into a life he just went to painful lengths to make clear he barely even considered worth living himself.
Ready when you are.
Yeah, I'm continuing. I'm trying to. You have no intention of inheriting, honoring that inheritance. The contract was worthless partially because you never agreed to it, but more importantly, you gained insight into its author in the process of watching him die. You didn't lose respect for him. It was somehow worse than that. You began to question his agency as a human being. You began to question his humanity itself. As the sickness tore away at him, it took little bits of his mind along the way. Your father's intellect and personality were being dismantled in such an alarming way. In such alarming ways, you began to wonder if you even knew what a human being was anymore. But you don't really wonder anymore. You think you simply understand now. Sorry about that, viewer, if you heard that. You drinking some water. But you don't really wonder anymore. You think you simply understand now. A person is a phenomenal illusion, carefully held together by healthy neurons, which once disrupted appear as a series of hellish algorithms firing the wrong way all the time. The express purpose of creating horror in all those who believe they loved him. They believed they loved him because they believed he was real, not merely a jumble of algorithmic insanity which just happened to be executing in a proper sequential order most of the time. Is that what you are too? A bunch of psychopathic inhuman algorithms firing until you get everyone who joins your movement killed? Or if your algorithms aren't quite satisfied with that, until you rip this country apart and get everyone killed? The coughing fits are heavier now, more frequent. No, this must be her influence. It makes no sense in any scientific way, but you can just feel it. Her ghostly hand closing around your throat, your dad's curse is bestowing his existential insanity upon you. The burden of striving for the American dream, which cracked your brain and sent you running away for good. Your mom never forgave you for it. Her dying curse is this disease, the same one that claimed her, and you know how she thinks. Why shouldn't you have to suffer the same way she did? COVID-19 is highly contagious, but you wonder if anyone's yet realized it can be transmitted psychically by a vengeful spirit. It's probably time to just throw in the towel, just stop all this running and hiding, and turn yourself over to the cops before you can endanger anyone else. Sure, you'd disappoint a lot of people that way. Millions have become deeply invested in your defiance of this brutal imperialistic police state. But the disappointment resulting from letting them all down would be a blessing at this point, relative to the scale of damage that the misfires of your algorithms, algorithmic insanity could truly be capable of. Maybe you don't even need to turn yourself in. Maybe the fact that your mom is trying to kill you here and now is her final act of mercy for you and everyone else. Maybe it'll just knock you off before you even get the chance to realize your full destructive potential.
Go ahead, you... you bitch! This is what you wanted! Isn't it, Mom? So go ahead and fucking drag me... into the fucking grave with you already!
Deep fried meme status.
Yeah, I did like that about it.
You're getting deep fried.
Thank you. You know?
Hey, I make the onomatopoeias here, bitch!
No, what if we leave with all that? We leave the viewers to ponder everything that was just read to them.
Yeah, you know what? What if we did? And we will.